I've come to the party in my big ass coat. I'm sitting down at the party, and everybody's at the party. It could be 3 a.m., it could be 5 in the afternoon, and I'll still be at the party. I'm adjusting my nice hair, and I'm sitting cross-legged. Oh, I took off my shoes. Well, I took off those goddamn shoes. So I'm reclining in my safety coat, you know? This coat is the one thing. This place that lets me even feel secure at all. So, we're at the party, and everybody is drinking. And everybody is drinking for not at all cheap. You know? Soda's like $7. The soda's $7. Man, I wish the fucking soda was $7. Come on, I've stopped shoplifting already. I've stopped shoplifting long ago. I wish I had a justification for doing so. And everybody is at the party. Everybody's at the party having a good time. Everybody's talking about the billionaire success man. They're talking about the from shit piss nobody poor gentrified geriatric dead building buzzboy to shit dirt space travel. Passport is public, credit card information is public, and yet they're still protected by the government. They're literally so easy to kill, yet they haven't been killed. Billionaire mindset, crypto gods, Bezos Light, Bezos Ultra. That's the kind of people they talk about. Those are the people from the party. The party man, the lives of the party. That's just everybody's at the party. That's what they're doing. That's what they're getting at. Okay. So you know, like, I scratch my hair a lot, flip my hair back. I'm doing this just for you. I'm doing this just for you. I'm doing this just for you. I'm at the party wearing my security coat.
And I'm not okay.
I'm at the party trying not to piss blood. I've already pissed blood. I got into the bathroom with this girl named Jenny, and she was doing coke, I think. Yeah, I was in the bathroom. I was at the urinal minding my goddamn business. Then I felt a trepidation in my skull, and I felt a rupture in my heartbeat. And I fell limp on my fucking knees, and I was losing my vision, and I felt like the whole reality was collapsing in front of me. The nature of this world is that it's a polluted world. Aquaculture, overfishing, hydro plant, hydro termination, aqua nova, ars nova, triton looking shit. Do you know triton wasn't actually banned by the Catholic Church? And did you know that no jazz musician is actually good at the wings? Like, they're not being required to play the wing by crooning at the time god. Is registered there. Jesus. A necessary thing requires a microphone. A microphone that you never like performance game mingling, social anxiety relief, destroying your boundaries between minorities so we can help that everybody's at the party. Everybody's at the party. We're not having a good time. Well, okay, I'm under my security code. That's what I'm doing. I'm at the party, ignoring the celebrity man, the party man. I'm looking over at the frat bros with their tech wear, all day the Google Glass that went out of style like 8 years ago, and they're wearing it. They're wearing it. It's cinema verity. It's the truth, a documentary. It's a documentary of society in its natural environment. And the waterfalls of awkward hitting on it, numb repressed, decoded, unaffiliated, megalomaniacal, narcissistic, abusive, terrifying, like luster, Herculean helical explosive godlike divinity. Iridium Mandelian Mandela. Hexagon kaleidoscope of failure. Everybody's at the party, just witnessing the shapes, you know. They're getting the ropes of the party, they're pulling the ropes. They're pulling the ropes and they're good at it. They're playing their songs. Their cute songs of failure and
course industrial accident.
Something out or another. Anxiety.
They're screaming right now.
So should I block it out? Okay. Everybody at the party is not screaming yet. But I mean, they'll be screaming. The screaming is a natural part of the party. Everybody's at the party. They're trying not to scream, but all the screaming out loud at the top of their lungs. In the back of their throat. In the back of their throat, there's a larynx wanting to let out scream. A scream is not let out. A scream is contained. A scream is burned into their lungs. And their lungs are blocked out. Airways covered by mucus. Bloody rain flow. Taxi cab. Insane driver that doesn't speak. Mucus. I'm wearing my safety hat. Everybody's at the party putting on their safety hat, the I am socially secure hat. The green thing that covers their face lets them trip.
Waves, pure atheism, rain world of no suffering ever. Ethereal rain world, sun stacks, money and tits and dick fuck and ambivalence and ambulance strips for free and universal
healthcare and snowfall in August and June benchmarks for human development in that we narrowly avoided the rapid spiking of temperature. We talk about all that with my rural middle class offshore mansion Swiss bank account, British drug smuggling aunt, rich prostitute that takes credit cards, Orthodox Christian Catholic rapist priest, deliberated 41-year-old uncle with multiple charges of manslaughter who says the word faggot a lot. At mostly young man that have like a mullet or a buzz cut or haven't taken care of their hair for like 17 years or taking their hair cut and they're pointing out their socks and their safety cards. Listen here, there's a dark, big mystery. A witch's home. A witch's home and to let that everybody at the party is entering. Okay, they have to get in. They're talking to the carpet. The carpet has a mouth, and the carpet has a doll on it. And doll offers a security mask. Doll in that hut tells her, everybody at the party, that's her full name. Say it once, everybody at the party. And Toll tells everybody at the party how to take care of the house, how to dust the carpet, how to beat the fuck out of it, how to find out the china, how to make it into rest, how to make life into rest, how to gain an interest in preparing your beds for your witch master who will strap you up here in that house of chicken legs. And everybody at the party did good at those things. Get them. They point their heads up in a pride. They're wearing these hands. They're leaning back on the couch and knowing that the doll is gonna instruct them. The instructions, they're gonna get good. The instructions will be for everybody in the party. Including everybody at the party in the room. Who's part of everybody in the party. I know it's getting confusing, but, you know, throw it aside. Eternal perpetual rainfall is getting really good. Eternal perpetual rainfall. It's all no concern to me, right? It's all no concern to me. The rainfall hit the stammering loose legs on walking stilts. Bizarre chair legs. CEO chair legs. Liberty man identity crisis. Rupture. Party boy. Reckless party boy. The government sees you fall back into the floor. Okay, I fell back. I'm sorry. Not wearing my safety clothes, I'm sweating my ass over here. So I'm looking at the trail outside. The fire is up behind, the cold's blowing. I gotta change the name. I gotta change for everybody in the party. Then I have to bribe everybody in the party with.
I am everybody in the party. She takes bribes and only tiny coins, right? Let me show you some coins. I'm reaching for her and I'm talking up, watching everybody in at the party look back at me in interest. I'm scratching my face up.
I'm just tingling my cool in anticipation that I'm not being able to find my actual change, man. So everybody at the party remains impressed. Then I suck at it. I suck at this everybody at the party thing being everybody at the party and everybody at the party. That's okay. Everybody at the party, you know? Finally, I've got change. Change the number I spend. Bar still will spend on. The last repair spent on cat shit, litter, dumps, and I'm gonna explode. Quickly and very sternly, and soon the knife will explode.
If we win trilogy of explosions,
quickly we win a very sternly essentially. Now that will be essential.
If we win trilogy of explosions,
They've
grown conditioned by the butler to wear social security needs.
I got a new one
came getting to the party.
I'm not wearing it.
I'm not wearing that damn mask in a thousand fucking years.
I'm thinking right now.
What if I were to break out of this party?
Consequences for that.
Cause me, I guess. As the consequences of leaving the party. I'm starting to think about an old ship at this party. About a chair that was being transported from Portugal to France called Trilogy Renee. Trilogy Renee, you know, she was part of a noble chair. A noble maplewood chair tree. You know, bloodline chairs. She was being transported in this shitty maiden voyage storage ship that nobody remembers anymore. I think it was the Emeraldia. And there, on the Emeraldia, there were many people that ended up there was Trilogy Renee. Chests of raw unrefined emeralds, and she was standing between us. And so many huge blocking chests around her. If even the wind or the storm won't allow the ship to anchor, to hit this fucking ship. Chests would go running without her, and she'd fall overboard into the sea, and Trilogy Renee would disappear, and she required social security names. Well, fuck no, she ain't gonna have it. So she throws out this social security mask as the walls of the ship collapse and the crew submerged in cargo and the sharks start to circle like the shark fin suit that is sentient animated 3D computer graphics IMAX 4K 5G broadband Google Glass Stadia fiber full diet consumption of power and energy. And they're gonna fall back into the ocean and eat scalp, seaweed, sand, gravel. Like the trilogy Renee, she's down here alone. She's down there alone. No. And I can't fucking stress how painful it felt to be alone down there, she says. Never once in a thousand years have I witnessed something so deeply terrifying and dear. Everybody spotted the party that came from the village. I'm gonna see this they aren't looking at her because they're too busy. They're coming. Body is dead now, he's in gravel. And true as you're getting, she, you know, is never, never, ever, ever. You got her, so she's down there on the sandy beach, running that trash, like ocean cargo. I think there's another ship next to her, this buried treasure. There's somebody's front seat, there's gold seat, grand pianos, there's acoustic guitars, there's flutes, there's prize and seat cloak, a flawless feet, and there's an input husband joy, and this is a trashy gold man under supervision of which a giant plastic patch of garbage would form in the ocean much later. And Trilla Jimene, she, you know, still has a will of what she's doing yet. Trilla Jimene, you think she's still down there? Yes, she is. Trilla Jimene, she's just the best. She's just the greatest, I guess. She's doing her best, you know? Trilla Jimene, she was left behind by everybody at the party. And she doesn't have to wear a coat. Because the wings of the phone lost her. The plastic comes down to knock her over. Makes her excited about shellfish. Shellfish creates intrusive content. And the shellfish wriggle on the floor. Trilogy of Nate. She's hot girl from there. And she's ripping on the floor. She's in pain. And it's like, it's like, we'll see you here. It's interesting. Seriously, it's a sad story. It's a sad, sad reenactment. It's for everybody in the party.